A very good morning to all. Today, we are going to discuss our English workbook, chapter number 4, and name of the chapter is Anu and Vijay. And you can open your textbook. And this chapter is the link lesson of what we have learned in the English reader, why Neil had no friends. So first, you have a passage given. You have a reading comprehension. Let's read this. Let's understand what it is. Then we'll answer the following questions. So, read what Anu says about her friend Vijay. So, let's read it. My name is Anu. So, this is a little girl named Anu. I have a friend. His name is Vijay. So, she is talking about her friend. You know what his name? His name is Vijay. I like him a lot. And she likes her friend a lot. We play football together. We also play hide and seek. We like to read storybooks too. Then she tells what they like to do together. See, they like to play football together. They like to play hide and seek. Even they like to read storybooks. We eat lunch together in school. Even they have lunch together in school. So this is Anu, and Anu's friend's name is Vijay. And they do everything together. So what all they like to do? They like to play football together. They like to read storybooks together. Even they like to play hide and seek. Even they eat their lunch together. So this is about Anu's friend named Vijay. So below that you have some questions given. So let's read out and answer these questions. So these questions are based on the reading passage. So first, I'm going to read out this passage and you have to write the answer over here. Then let's discuss the answers. So let's read the first question. Write T for true and F for false. For the statements which are true, you have to write T. And for statements which are false, you have to write F. So I'll read out the question and you can write the answer over the space. First one, the two friends are Anu and Vijay. If the statement is true, what you have to write? You have to write here T. And if the statement is false, what you have to write? You have to write it as F. So you can write the answer here. Next, Anu and Vijay like to sing. Third one, the friends like to play football. The next one, they do not read storybooks. Fifth one, Anu eats lunch with Vijay. See the sixth one. Anu and Vijay play hide and seek. So these are the questions. I hope you have written the answers here. So let's see the answers. The two friends are Anu and Vijay. So what is the answer here? Is it true or false? It is true. So answer is true. You can write here T. What about the next one? Anu and Vijay like to sing. So in the reading passage, it is not mentioned anywhere that they like to sing. So is the statement true or false? Is the statement is false. So we'll write here F. What about the third one? The friends like to play football. The passage clearly says that they like to play football. So what is the answer? The answer is true. What about the next one? They do not read storybooks. So the question is they do not read storybooks. But this passage says that they like to read storybooks together. So the statement here is false. So the answer is F. So it is false. Anu eats lunch with Vijay. What is the answer? Answer is true. They have lunch together. Anu and Vijay play hide and seek. So what is the answer? Answer is true. They play hide and seek together. So let's write here T. Coming to the next exercise, we have already learned about opposites. So here you have about 10 questions given here. And what you have to do here is, from these box, you have to find the opposite words for these words. Let's start with the first one, long. So what is the opposite word for long? If I say, I have a long pencil. What is the opposite for long? Long, short. I have a long pencil. I have a short pencil. So the opposite for long is short. Even the word short is given here. So let's write here short. S-H-O-R-T. There. The second word. What is the second word given here? Quiet. So what is the meaning of quiet? Quiet means silent. She is quiet. That means very silent. So then what is the opposite word for silent? One who makes sound. So the opposite for quiet is loud. Loud means one who makes so much sound. So what is the opposite word for quiet? Loud. L-O-U-D. Next one. The third one. Never. So let me give you an example. I have never seen this picture anywhere. So can you say what is the opposite word for never? If I say, I always like to do this. Always. Always means all the time. So the opposite word for never is always. A-L-W-A-Y-S. Then, what about the next one? Low. Low means less. Then what is the opposite word for low? Low, high. H-I-G-H. So even the word is given here. Then, see the next one. Full. The bucket is full of water. That means it is filled with water. Then what is the opposite word for full? Full, empty. Empty means nothing. So let's write here. Empty. E-M-P-T-Y. So the word is given here. Then, next one. Slow. What is the opposite word for slow? She walks slow. Then, what is the opposite word for slow? Fast. She runs fast. F-A-S-T. So likewise, you have four more words given here. So what you have to do is, you have to find the opposite words for the following four words. So you can find the answers from the box. You have to find the opposite word for narrow, far, light, sweet. And the answers are in the box. You have to find the answers and you have to write it down in the space given. Okay. Coming to the next one. Rewrite these sentences with opposites. So here you have five sentences given. And what you have to do is, you have to rewrite these sentences with the opposites. So let's read the first one. Rima wore a short dress. So short is underlined here. So what is the opposite word for short? We already discussed just now. Opposite word for short. Short, long. So you have to rewrite the sentence with the opposite. So how can we write that? Rima, R-I-M-A, Rima wore a, so instead of short, we use the opposite word long. So let's write here long, then we'll write dress, D-R-E-S-S. So this is how you have to rewrite the sentence with opposites. See the next one. The water is clean. So you have to find the opposite word for clean. So clean means very neat and tidy. So how we rewrite this sentence? We can write it as the water is dirty. So the opposite word for clean is dirty. So I'll write your dirty here and you have to rewrite the sentence. You have to write it as a sentence. Water is dirty. Coming to the next one. These pillows are soft. So you all know pillows. So they are very soft. Soft means very smooth to touch. So what is the opposite word for soft? Opposite word for soft is hard. So the opposite word of soft is hard. So you have to rewrite the sentence. How we write it? You have to write it as these pillows are hard. The opposite word for soft is hard. Next one. These grapes are not sweet. So the word sweet is underlined here. So you have to find the opposite word for sweet. So opposite word for sweet is sour. So you have to write it as these grapes are not sour. So the sentence becomes these grapes are not sour. What about the fifth one? This one you have to find the opposite word and you have to rewrite the sentence. This cup of tea is hot. So the word hot is underlined and you have to find the opposite word for hot. And you have to rewrite this sentence. This you have to do it by yourself. We have discussed some of the exercises. So in the coming classes, we'll discuss the remaining exercise. So we'll meet in the next class. So till then, thank you.